Toy Story stock reel. The show there is knocked off. Like before, when sorry about that again. Let's just knock me off. I think it's Rich Allen goes right in it. I'm wrong, but. That sounds shady, but that's an essay. It's been a while. Come on, that should have went out. Yeah. Take pitches, it doesn't count against Italian. Same with Nisa, it doesn't count against the swings. Unless you're in the, unless it's like, being a swing all. There it goes! Wow! 28! Woo! I was hot that round! He finishes with 28 shit. Home runs, and that puts him into the championship matchup. I didn't even need post time. As amazing as that sounds. Come on.
That's number five. It's gone. He has earned an additional bonus time. His third consecutive home run. That's number four in a row. 3 minutes to go.
Come on, yes. Fair, damn it. Let's say fair.
Number 20 in the round.
One more. Okay, BLP before both time. Nope. Damn it. This guy had to go to both time to beat him. There we go. The champ is still here, baby. Just swinging to the bonus time and I win it. I think I'm just gonna skip the All-Star game. I could keep fucking... Gonna keep the glitch. They ain't gonna fix it. Right, it's a known glitch. They ain't fixing it. Come on for Boston, Baltimore, and San Francisco. And back out on the road.
This is the MLB pregame show, and I'm Matt Vasgersian, and as we draw nearer to the first pitch of Game 1 in the series, we'll give you the latest installment of our Topps Player Spotlight. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, is in that spotlight. And not only was he an all-star during the midseason break, but he also shined the brightest out of all the great players in the game as he won the All-Star Games MVP award.
You know, that's one of those honors, Matt, that's just really cool to get.
I think it's a cop-out. It's not really a fucking reaction. I wasn't.
Rain falling here in the tri-state area as we close in on game time at Yankee Stadium. Tonight, the first of this three-game... Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, gets his first cuts now. The bases are empty, and there are two away here in the opening frame. Stung into the gap in right center for what should be extra bases. Around first, heading for second now, and he's not stopping. He wants three, and he will make it all the way to third now as that mistake proves a costly one indeed. So a struggle that time for him in center field. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will step in now with three home in the inning and another two men out there on base.
This inning's really starting to unravel quickly.
Oh, yeah.
From a defensive point of view, this is where you need a nice pop-up in a big way.
And they'll extend their lead even further as the runs in to score from third. Around third and being waved on home. And not in time as the second run scores.
Well, this is what happens when you dig yourself a hole out there on the mound.
Stepping in, Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here.
Well, he's batting lefty right now, but does it matter? He can hit from either side of the plate.
And this will
have to leave the home run for the cycle.
He's aboard with a single. So standing in, Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, and all eyes are on him as he needs a home run to complete the cycle.
And he knows it too, guys. Let's see if he can send a jolt through one right here.
Jew is there.
Not be there unless he's in the fucking stands, which means he's on run anyway. Because you can't catch.
So coming to the plate, Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, as he's
grow a set of balls and pitch to me. Grow a set of balls and pitch to me, you fucking coward.
An entertaining game all in all.
You're a fucking pussy. Plus it should be 6-5, I fucking run. It was 6-6 anyway. What the fuck are you smoking? You're smoking crack game. You're smoking the crack again game. You have to, because if you think that's fucking the way out, that was a fucking.
About set for baseball now on the show. As
you boy.
Here in the Bronx. Today, it's the second of this three-game series.
What the fuck is this happened?
Three hits in the win last night.
And he's been hitting the ball out of the yard, too. A whole bunch of home runs. And yesterday was a good one, too.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Dark Ball Baseball. Well, it looks like trying to play at night in Yankee Stadium with no lights on. Okay, this is getting worse. There we go. We're playing during an eclipse.
Count is full. Here's the pitch. Skied in the air.
I didn't know we could play during an eclipse.
Under at Jew. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over.
What the fuck was that?
Another shot. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness. He reached on a single in his first try. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Hit high and deep to left field.
I think it was the game with some warning of what's going to happen to the Sun in 2029.
Ready to take his axe again. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, as he'll look to follow up the two-run homer he launched over the wall last time up.
Hit hard. No, it was past them.
Relay not in time as he beats the throw by a step.
Well, you could have put the first base bag out in the outfield grass on this play. You're not going to double this guy up. He's too fast. Still, a pretty good job of at least getting that lead runner at second base.
Swing and miss on the slurve that time. It's 1-2. Seemed to quicken his delivery to the plate on that last pitch.
Well, you got to remember the slide step does two things.
Oh, but he thought
it's a mess. As he aborted the slide step there.
Headed back to first. Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Here's the pitch on 2-2. He's on the move again. For
yeah, okay.
Still 2-2. Runner on first, two away, all tied at 3 apiece. And now he's on the move again for second. Sent on the ground out to second. Throw to first easily, and the side is retired. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will stride in, but first we take you back to the third as you take another look here at his two-run homer that had him rolling early on. Taken high and deep to right.
That's gone.
Ranging back.
It's only one out.
Gone.
See?
Fence scraper, but still good for
that was a fence scraper. This is barely get out.
So it's a three-run shot to straightaway right field. His second of the game, as this is now a seven-run ball game.
Well, it seems to me like we've seen this before. His second home run of the ball game. And it would seem to me that he hit that one harder than he did the last one. So he's definitely locked in.
Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, stands in again here with two home runs already to his name in this one.
And you know what, Matt? He's just made it look so easy out there.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. They're up comfortably, however. It's 10-4. fellas. As always, a few guys we could have chosen from, but out of everybody, that's the man who stands out in my book. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, he delivered more than once with runners in scoring position. Finished with five RBIs, and that was more than enough to lead his guys to victory.
So that'll just about do it for us this afternoon. Thanks to Eric Carroll, Steve Lyons, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. Find out more, head on over to theshownation.com. The Yankees come out on top 10-4. So long from the Bronx.
Our final night score this afternoon, first for the victorious Yankees. 10 runs, 13 hits, 3 errors. They left 7 runners on base. For the Red Sox, 4 runs on 5 hits, 1 error, and 11 runners left on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 44 minutes.
Back here on the MLB pregame show, Matt Vasgersian getting you set for the finale of this three-game set. That'll come your way in mere moments, but first, we'll take a look at the Topps player spotlight. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will be our subject, and not only was he an all-star during the mid-
Seriously, fix that glitch. Alright. Fix it. I think you fix it. You can fucking fix Dark Ball and Big Ball and all that. Let's just start with the last one. You can fix that. You can fix that.
Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, gets his first cuts now. The bases are empty, and there are two away here in the opening frame. A diving effort here as he gets a glove on it. And not really much of a chance to recover there as he'll reach first on what... Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will step in now with three home in the inning and another two men out there on base.
This inning's really starting to unravel quickly from a defensive point of view.
There's a swing.
There it goes.
Just going to sit back and watch that one fly. A no doubt home run. So a three-run shot to right center field. So he just continues to club the baseball at an alarm. Into the box, Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness. He went deep in his first at bat. We'll see what he's got in store for us here.
Yeah, he jumped all over a first pitch fastball in that at bat, just drove it right out of here. But let's see if he's aggressive early in the count once again.
Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will stand in as we'll flash you back to the second inning as you get a look at this key three-run home run. Smoke the other way, high and deep to left. Jew going back on it, and a leaping effort at the wall, but it's in vain, a home run. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will get a shot here in a bases-loaded situation, and you'd have to say they've got the right man for the job up here.
Yeah, team leader in RBIs. He's got a shot to push the...
Now, ooh! Grant's on, let me know that about it. Whoo!
And it's a grand slam. So he promptly unloads the bases with that one. His third home run of the ball game as they've widened this lead to 8 now.
Well, we wonder what...
And another bases loaded situation.
Stands in the 8th batter of the inning now with the bases loaded and 2 away.
Yeah, you know, and this could get ugly in a hurry. Or pretty, I guess, depending on which dugout you're sitting in.
And this is turning ugly now as this ball's down for extra bases. 2 runs have scored. The tag.
He's on the base! Are you fucking smoking crack? You have to be if you think he's out. He's on the base! He's clearly on the base before the tag. You still call him out just to be a black game. If not, way baseball's supposed to go. If he's safe, he's safe. 3 runs scored in that play game, including the guy before. You supposedly tagged me out even though I was on the base. But why is it 17-4 when it's 15-5? Why not doing him, please?
Let's start this from the happy end.
Baltimore's coming down. Survival. The daily deed. I'm hands down winning the MVP. They're in close.
This is the MLB pregame show, and I'm Matt Vasgersian, and as we draw nearer to the first pitch of game... Closing in on first pitch this evening from Yankee Stadium here in the Bronx. Tonight it's the first of four between the Baltimore Orioles and the New York Yankees. It's baseball, it's the show, and it comes your way next. With that, here's how Buck Showalter lines his Orioles up in this one. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, strides forward with a hot bat in his hands. Great numbers over the past few games. He's set. Here it comes. Popped high in the air.
Bullshit.
Ramirez is there for it. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. With that, it's time to check out the starting lineup for the hometown Yankees. Anybody catch your eye? Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, in now, popped out in his first trip.
Yeah, he just uppercut a fast.
Hang on, this is hit deep into right center. This looks to have enough, and it does, a home run. Into the box, Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, and he'll be looking to add on to his two RBIs from earlier. Hit hard on the ground towards second, and this is knocked down over there, and they'll wind up with...
Thank God they actually gave me a hit, man. Oh, man.
Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will stride in, but first we take you back to...
What
the
fuck? Pitch to me! Hey, so another thing, fucking... Let us turn this off. Or fucking stop making AI fucking pit walk us all the time. We want to play the fucking game. We're not here to watch the fucking pitcher and us do nothing. And when you do that, you just make us do nothing. Bullshit.
Now as the inning is over. So they're held in check here this half of the inning. Now the beautiful views of
New York.
Welcome back to baseball.
The beautiful they named it twice. Here in the Big Apple.
An entertaining game all in all. So if we have to choose one who stood out among all others, why not go with this man right here? He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, you see a couple of hits for him in the ball game. This one was tight throughout, but in the end, he really helped lead his guys to this victory.
Both teams getting their final warm-ups in as we welcome you back to the MLB pregame show. First pitch of game two in our series is right around the corner. But before we turn that corner, here is our Topps player spotlight. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will be in the glow. And not only was he an all-star during the midseason break, but he also shined the brightest out of all the great players in the game as he... Tuesday night baseball now from Yankee Stadium here in the Bronx. Tonight the second of four to begin the week between the Baltimore Orioles and the New York Yankees. Which of these two will prevail? Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will stride in now. Two hits for him, including a home run in last night's contest.
And he's been hitting the ball out of the yard, too. A whole bunch.
Get up! Yeah.
That ball will stay fair, and it's gone. A home run.
It just barely stay fair.
Now batting. Ready to take his
hit. But it's fair.
Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, as he'll look to follow
well,
up.
Okay, it's... Oh, man, it's...
Last time up. Massive racing back.
That one's gone, too.
And goodbye. This one ain't coming back.
It went long, but then they were over the wall into the stands. But, man, it's...
His dudeness will get a shot here in a bases-loaded situation, and you'd have to say they've got the right man for the job up here. This ball gets down. Let's see if they try to score. One run scores. And the run is in to score from second. And he is in there. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will stand in again as we flash you back to the early stages of this ball game. There were fans still finding their seats as he launched his second home run of the game as he was off to a fast start indeed. That's through for a base hit, and he's putting together a monster line in this one. They just can't get him out.
That I can't.
Joseph Ruiz gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point. Runners off for second. Pitches a called strike.
I was hoping for the death of the ball. Come on.
And now a right-hander up and throwing in the Baltimore bullpen. Throw over to the bag. A dive, but he's back. He's running again. Pitch outside. The throw. And it's far too late as he steals second with ease.
Sometimes in a situation like this, you wonder if the delayed steal might be on from third. And this time it wasn't, and the throw was not even close to second base.
Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, is set to take some more swings. He homered back in the third inning.
I'm in the first and third inning. And then they hit
and his fine ball game will continue. Give him a
God over the bullpen. Whew. That was a long shot.
So a two-run shot.
That went back to this.
His third home run of the ball game, as this is now a five-run cushion.
And you wonder why I was stealing. Six run lead, no, seven to four run. We only win by four.
We could have chosen from, but out of everybody, that's the man who stands out in my book.
No lead is safe in this game.
Yeah, seemed like everything he does turned to gold. Winds up with five hits in the game.
Back live now on the MLB pregame show. Just baseball from the Big Apple. We're at Yankee Stadium in the Bronx. Tonight it's game three of this four-game set. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will stride forward now, and one would imagine he'll be pitched to very carefully as he's coming off a three-home run ball game a night ago. And
I wouldn't go there. I mean, that's good idea. I'm not going on that one. I like to steal second, but it's better than not to get thrown a third. I'm getting none of that in the first. It's 7-0. Holy shit.
Left-handed here.
Well, he's batting lefty right now, but does it matter? He can hit from either side.
Seven runs.
It's one of those things that you fit, if you're the manager, you want to start pulling your hair out. Frustration.
Hard hit ball to
second. Oh, bullshit.
And it's in time at first, and hallelujah.
Hallelujah, the inning is over.
Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, stands in with two on and two out here in the third.
And you know, some guys just get better with runners in scoring position and two outs. This is a big at-bat for him right here, even though it's still early.
And the runner from second is
going to be a two-run double.
And a relay home. See? And not in time as the second run scores.
10-1. 11-2.
Dudenstein, his dudeness, comes to the plate as we get started here in the bottom of the fifth.
Well, you know, he's been on base twice in this one already, so let's see if he can do it again.
Get up!
To deep center field, and he will run this.
How did he, how? Unless his fucking arm can go through the wall, that ball was obviously, we saw it over the wall. It was not a catch ball, that was a fucking run. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Just hitting.
And this one's not coming back. This is
and then I went back to dust. I went back to dust.
Now batting. So standing in, Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, and we'll see if he can get something into the gap to make it interesting. He's had a great game so far, but needs the triple to complete a cycle. Around third and being waved on home.
Thank you for being, because I ended up getting the third and ended up at the cycle.
Hit for the cycle. That's a great thrill for him and everyone here in attendance.
Thrilling indeed, Matt. I've witnessed a few others besides this one, and it's exciting for everyone, even broadcasters. It's a very rare thing in our sport, and it always
this guy plays.
So it's pretty cool for everyone here watching to see a little piece of baseball history.
So a good job of collectively swinging the bats in this one, but if we had to single out one guy who outshined all others, I think it's the man who stands out right here. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, just a great all-around
game. Hey, I missed it. I'm going to highlight it. I'm going to highlight it. Definitely highlight it. The sun went out.
As you get a look at Yankee Stadium here in the Bronx. Today it's the finale.
We had a day game against Boston a couple of games ago, and it looked like we were playing in a total eclipse or something. The sun just blacked out.
Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, digs into the box in the bottom of inning number three. Hit hard towards center, and that'll get down for a base hit. So he goes after the first pitch, and it's early trouble here this half of the inning. Already two hits in the ballgame. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, strides into the box now. Launched one over the wall back in the opening frame. Hard liner to center field. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
Boy, how much hotter is he going to get? He's got himself another three-hit ball game. That batting average is going to continue to climb even higher.
Runners going. Pitch misses low. The throw down.
Safe. Bullshit.
Perfect throw.
Bullshit, even if he was a perfect throw. That didn't get me, you liar. Again, it's a lying in the team.
Great throw to second base, and he's gone.
Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will stand in here, but before he does,
lying in team again. Lying in team.
This was a two-run home run right out of the gate that really got these guys off to a fast start. Oh, and he gets a
and that one fast to death. So is another one. A doubt about it. Like I said, no back to this.
His dudeness, and we'll see if he can put together a rare performance here.
And that one back to this. Let's crush that one.
Way out of here.
Hey, Amon Wells. Emmanuel's Animals?
Yeah, he delivered more than
one. Emmanuel's four.
Finished with five RBIs, and that was more than enough to lead his guys to victory.
So that'll just about do it for us this afternoon. Thanks to Eric Carroll, Steve Lyons, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasker.
Sorry if it's butchering your name, I'm trying to I'll say it. The touch! Man. The power! Yeah, San Francisco, I'm gonna use them with two more series. Did I? Winner!
This is the
I love the song,
man.
Yeah. Soundtrack of my childhood, Transformers the movie cinema. Yeah, the more I was saying it, the more I realized it. Like, Emmanuel's. Like, oh, that's right. I'm sorry. I was trying more I said it, the more I was getting it.
night, but he also like, shined the brightest out of all the great players in the game as he won the All-Star. A great start to the weekend here as we've got baseball from Yankee Stadium in the Bronx. Tonight, the first of this three-game weekend series. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will dig in now, right on the heels of driving in five runs in yesterday's ball game.
And he's been hitting the ball out of the yard, too. A whole bunch of home runs in his last 10 games. And yesterday was a good one, too.
And he is in there.
A good job here.
Yep. Lifelong Yankee fan.
Shoots his ball right back up the middle.
Aaron Brundtland will stand in, and as you take a look at the splits there, he's actually a better hitter against right-handed pitching.
Been since I was a kid. I mean, I got. In fact, I don't know how long we had this. We had the I think my dad bought this back in 78.
Runners off for second. Pitch swung out and missed.
But we had, I had a glass photo frame, not the glass, just like yeah, it was the glass of the 70 like Yankee team, and then we had bullshit went past them. You fucking can't fucking tag me out in that play. You're fucking not fast enough.
Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, steps one in, one out, and one on here in the inning.
That's been a pretty good inning here so far. So
I don't even tag me, fucking deer.
Right here. Hit hard towards center. In there, the base hit. The relay throw, and he's safe. Hey. Striding into the box, Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness. He singled his last time up.
And they take another single right here, too, no doubt. Runner in scoring.
And now, meanwhile, here's a
goes. I went back to this. Lifelong. And then we have, I used to be in my room, it's still in the basement. It was a photo of, like, all the players from the 78 team.
This was a big blow, a two-run home run.
Like, this is Gov Gov Dino's born. Gov Gov Go. Yeah, wait.
Third and being waved on home. And they're not going to get him. He's in there at the
so, that made it more special. And then that was like right before Darren Munson died. I did play it on Sundays. It's just actually I'm playing to play on Sundays for SummerSlam. Is it? MLB's. I do on Wednesdays because it's special. I usually would have cast it on Wednesdays anyway. And it's just like gives me an opportunity to play like more WWE, more band, more NBA, more. NHL was a fucking stupid, being stupid with season career modes and you know. Gives me more opportunity to play them on Sundays. And I was like, because that. So, it's hand because, like, there have been a lot of Sundays lately. I just hadn't felt like playing anything. Really my fault. Every couple of Sundays, right, I just had really bad days going on, really bad situations. It couldn't be helped.
First pitch of game two
and just that was going on at this freaking. I skipped that because usually it's just, they're saying the same thing. But here's the thing with this is, those who don't know is, with this, there's a glitch. Now if you win the All-Star game, I used to think if you win the All-Star, I used to think it was, if you win the All-Star game, in the next season start on the road. That's the only way the glitch would happen, because that's what happened. From what happened to me and what happened to Cubs. Because when it didn't happen, after I think I won the All-Star MVP, I started the season on the road. I started the season at home, excuse me. But this time, for some odd reason, starting the season at home AL's MVP. The first game they gave me the MVP for the season, and then the next game they started doing the All-Star MVP glitch. So it's either gotten worse, or they just haven't patched it, or they tried patching it and made it worse. I don't know. But like I said, I do it on Sundays. I rotate through, right now it's just WWE, Ben and NBA when I can on Sunday afternoon to the mark. I eat on Sunday night. I have a lot of created characters I've created myself. I use and some I've downloaded though. But a lot of guys I created that create out of the blue out of my head, really. You know.
Solo shot to right center.
Because I do that as. I do my own, like, little fan fiction league, of wrestling, called the, it's sort of like an alternate WWE, or it's just,
really a game to remember for that man right there.
I use WWE guys, I use sort of just about every, a bunch of different guys, just my own creative guys,
a
couple of storylines, couple of, but, my own stuff.
Getting you set for the finale of this three-game set. That'll come your way in mere moments, but first we'll take a look at the Topps player spotlight. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, is our subject. And not only was he an all-star during the midseason break, but he also shined the brightest out of all the great players in the game as he won the All-Star Games MVP.
Wait, say that's a glitch. Should be only doing it after you win the All-Star game. Not, like, 2 weeks afterwards.
Sunday for our national pastime from Yankee Stadium in the Bronx. Today it's the third and final game in this three-game interleague series between the San Francisco Giants and the New York Yankees. Should see some great battles out of these two next on the show. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will get his first shot now.
They actually, showed, I have pre-ordered, I gotta pay off more of it when I go next time. But they showed more of, W2K17, including ladders, where you can actually, put the ladder between the ring and they call it a barricade, it's fucking guardrail. It's a guardrail. It's a guardrail under a barricade, under like a plastic wall.
He's got it. A nice play there, two away.
But it's still guardrail. If you ever watch them like pull up the padding up on top of it, you still see the guardrail there. I mean, it's like somebody goes over the side, you still see the guardrail there. It's still guardrail. This is covered now. So, the video at the end showed they're placing the guard, taking the ladder out from underneath the ring and placing it between the ring apron and the barricade, guardrail, we're going to call it. And they changed the system away, grabbing the belt, too. They changed that, though. The ladder matches. We confirmed a bunch of people too, like AJ Styles, the Dudleys, New Day, Air Brooks.
I tell you, that's the perfect.
I also showed somebody else mentioned. I looked at is all on AJ's YouTube page. I see they also mentioned Just Shelf new backstage brawling. Really cool. Almost fell back to SmackDown in your face, the old SmackDown backstage brawling. It is really cool. Where it's like this one moment, or it's Randy Orton, Brock Lesnar brawling in, and Randy throws him into the door and then goes to follow him, and Triple H and Orton, they have a stare off before he goes in, because they're going to like Triple H's office, I guess. That was pretty neat. I said there's not an IGN's YouTube. Hey, we hit 350.
This is the MLB pregame show, and I'm Matt Vasgersian.
Thank you who just followed.
One in the series will give you the latest installment of our Topps Player Spotlight. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness is our focus. And not only was he an all-star during the midseason break, but he also... Welcome to Houston as we prepare you for baseball from Minute Maid Park. Tonight, the opener of a three-game series. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will dig in now, right on the heels of driving in five runs in yesterday's ball game.
Well, you look at the average on the season, guys, and he's not sneaking up.
Get up!
Pretty amazing numbers.
Yep.
See you later. Over the wall, a home run. So it's a solo shot to dead center. So he just continues to club the baseball at an alarming rate. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, stands in with two on and two out here in the third.
And you know, some guys just get better with runners in scoring position and two outs. This is a big at-bat for him right here, even though it's still
early. Damn it, drop it.
Schmoll is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great... Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will stand in again, but first we'll flash you back to the very first inning of the ballgame. And here you go, a solo home run that had him off and running early on. And
that's a base hit.
For a base hit. So he goes after the first pitch, and it's early trouble here this half of the inning.
Especially with a guy can run the
second hit of the ball game, and he's aboard on the leadoff single as we take a look at the league leaders in hitting.
Well, guys, he's one of the best in the league in that department right now. He has
a ball.
He's been locked in, and it's resulting in a lot of games like the one he's having here.
Roger Lopez will stand in again. A couple of groundouts for him on the ledger in his two trips so far. And in fact, he'll just look him back to the bag. Now the Astros have somebody up in the bullpen as a right-hander has started to warm up out there. Runner going a second time. Pitch misses low.
He doesn't even throw.
And no throw as he'll just hang onto it.
Oh, you swung that ball for it. What are you doing?
Time for the changeup. It's full 3-2. He took second fairly easily. Any thought of third base here?
I don't think so. You've got a good hitter at the plate. A single is probably all he needs. I'd let him try to
damn it.
Throw on to first, two gone. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will get a shot here in a bases loaded situation.
I should have put,
and you'd have to say they've got the
right
popped man for the job up here.
Yeah,
perfect.
Team leader in RBIs. We've got a shot to push that.
There we go.
Meanwhile, this ball gets down. It's a base hit.
Why aren't you going the third in it?
The run scores for second. It's a 5-4 game.
In the third in it.
Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, comes to the plate with the bases juiced, and it seems a big hit here could really put this one out of reach.
And pretty much any glimmer of hope for those
come on. Not be a pop up like that to be in the stands. Left further out.
Is in now to put it away, and that'll keep the runner from tagging.
Bullshit.
There will be no attempt. A handful of fine individual performances to choose from in this one, boys. But what do you say we go ahead and let
that sun right in his eyes?
Hardware. He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, no question he was a tough out up there. You see the three hits, including a home run. Without him in the lineup.
And Tuesday night baseball now from the home of the Astros, Minute Maid Park in Houston. Tonight, the second of three to start the week between the New York Yankees and the Houston Astros. It's baseball, it's the show, and it comes your way next.
Ooh, you can now clip some pants broadcasts.
So now let's take a look at Joe Girardi's lineup for the visiting Yankees.
Ow.
Eric, who should we keep an eye on?
Or Carlos.
Well, I think the focus has to be on the man hitting.
Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will stand in. He, too, had three hits in the win last night.
Well, you know, he's been averaging at least an RBI per game over his last 10. So
his highlights are more for, like, full, like, highlights and...
And even if this doesn't lead to
looks like every form of like little goofy stuff. So many catches on.
Maybe you force him to throw another, I don't know, 5, 6, 7 pitches to the next hitter.
Pitch is high, the throw. The throw is low, and he can't make the pick.
Oh, it's even that close.
In there and it
ball four. What the fuck are you smoking?
Astros entering play here tonight. They come in looking to turn things around as they've dropped two straight.
And in terms of the homestand, they've won that two ball. Lost two. So not much to say about that except you hate to give away games at home. You'd like to see a little more consistent effort going forward.
Line to the right side. Rosario is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. So they get a man to second here. Digging in the switch hitter, Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, he singled his last time up. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Line drive to center field. And that'll get down out there near the wall. Oh, and he runs right through the stop sign.
It's a good thing he did because he scored easily.
He's in there at the plate.
He's definitely in the middle of an MVP.
Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one.
You know, guys, I love a guy like this leading off.
Get up.
He makes good contact and he
comes yep, gone.
So a solo shot here to left. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, strides in now, and we'll see if he can come through with two on and two out here in the sixth. Swing, line, drive. That's going to be trouble. Around third and being waved on home. And the runner from second is in to score.
He just beats it. Wow. Nice running play. Nice decision there.
Well, this guy's been swinging a hot bat here in the series, so he can't call this unexpected. Just absolutely rakes this ball, and he's going to drive him two more on the double.
Now some action out in the Houston bullpen, as it appears both a lefty and a right-hander are up to throw.
Yeah.
Time as he just does get in there ahead of the throw.
And let's just train our camera on that runner leading off from second. He's watching that pitcher like a hawk, so once he sees that he's not paying attention to him, he just takes off. And the head first slide gets him into third just ahead of the throw.
Two, one, here it is.
Nope,
and he misses low here, so the count goes to 3-1.
Well, with every pitch it misses, he just keeps digging himself a deeper and deeper hole.
Now a
fastball. He's down 7-3.
3-2.
That hole you want to try to dig into.
He almost came out of his shoes on that one.
Rip down the line. Ooh. But this will get
fouled. I had to jump over it.
Do it again. 3-2. Full count here. Here comes the pitch. Neither guy
that's foul.
Give in, and the at bat will continue. And he'll step off and go to
third. He's safe. Bullshit. Again, you guys check. Yeah, I think they're fucking hands. His hands on the base.
moments in this one. Sir Dudenstein is Dudeness, and we'll see if he can put together a rare.
He balked anyway. We're starting to the plate.
First pitch of the at bat. Hit hard towards second, and that's another base hit for him. He's on a tear in this one. Around third and being waved on home. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late. Sir Dudenstein. Great. And a good offensive performance here, but I think. Player of the game.
And you know, a cycle is about the equivalent of a no-hitter for a pitcher. It's one of the rarest things you can do on a baseball field. So no doubt he's going to wind.
Back here on the getting ready for baseball under the roof in Houston today, getaway day here in this three-game series between the New York. Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness. We'll see if he can keep the magic wand going. He was 5-for-5 in the ball game last night.
Yeah, I don't think that's.
There's a swing and a ball in the air and a ball that he got every stitch
over the wall. And that was, I think that was out of the park.
So a three-run shot to left center. So he just.
That made it look like a gun. Alfred didn't fit in the hole.
His dudeness steps in with another shot to do some damage after hitting a three-run bomb in his first.
That one bites dust.
Drilled right back up the middle, and that'll find its way into center field for a one-out hit. So a ground ball single up the center of the diamond makes it two hits for him on the afternoon. And as that graphic shows us, he currently leads the Yankees in that category.
Yeah, this is nothing new, Matty. Another hit for him. And he's really the guy they need on to keep the line moving. He's been their most consistent hitter so far.
He's running towards second. Not quick enough there that time, and he's lucky to get another chance. Count remains full. Now a move over to first.
He's safe.
And a dive, but he's back in there. Runner at first here, one man out. He's running again. And another.
Come on.
Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one. This is in the air out to right. Rosales is going to get there to make the catch.
Bullshit.
Now, they may have a shot at doubling the runner at first. On to first.
They never let me go back.
Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, strides into the box now. Launched one over the wall back in the opening frame. Oh, and he gets a hold of this one.
Ooh, there's another one. That one bites the dust. That probably was out of the stadium.
It's a two-run shot to straightaway left. His second home run of the game as they stretch the lead to 5-1.
That pitcher's got to be thinking, how can I throw a pitch like that in this situation? That thing was so right down the middle, it absolutely got hammered, and he knew it as soon as he let go.
Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, stands
in the game. His dudeness.
Already to his name in this one.
And you know what, Matt? He's just made it look so easy out there. I think they've got to change their approach right here. Use some caution or something.
Around third and being waved on home. And the run will score all the way from first.
Don't look now, but he's closing in on what might be an historic.
Sir Dudenstein, his dudeness, will stand in again as he looks for home run number 3 in the ball game. As we flash you back here to his second home run. This was back in the fifth inning as he has the long ball working in his first few at-bats. And that's going to find the alley for his fifth hit of the ball game. And he will make it there to start the eighth. It's a leadoff double.
Wow. That's a motorcycle.
He's just completed the cycle, folks.
Wow, this guy is on fire. Stay hot out there. You know, this is pretty cool because a cycle just doesn't happen that often. What, do you see it once or twice in a year, unless your name's Aaron Hill, who did it twice in a year himself. So I'm pretty positive he's going to put this game right at the top of his career highlight reel.
Well, the bats were certainly working in this one, but out of everybody, I'd say this man most deserves to be our top player of the game.
And you know, a cyclist...
It's turning. That's why I make sure it's turning. Oops. Wrong button. Yep. Egg. Alex holds out and I don't even fucking understand. But yeah, that's gonna be it for today. We'll get back tomorrow. More America 8 with the Great DQ. Friday, we're gonna do Assassin's Creed Unity. Then with Saturday, Sunday, we'll do WWE 2K16. Sunday with America 8. And then back with Monday with more Assassin's Creed Unity, probably. That's, yep, kill me, schedule a new channel, you see if they're following. We got lots of goodies coming up, including we're continuing with Assassin's Creed Unity. We're going to be, because tomorrow will be Wednesdays. America 8. We're probably gonna go back to Fallout sooner or later, Fallout 4 sooner or later. We're trying Metal Gear Solid, Ratchet & Clank series in the future. So yeah, WWE 2K17. We're gonna be definitely doing Assassin's Creed Syndicate in the future. Actually, just got the game in today. So yeah, well, that's the games coming up. What's something else I was thinking I wanted to do before? Yeah, I'm trying to remember what it was. I thought it was something I wanted to do. I forget what it is now. Yeah, so follow me on social media so when I go live. Don't go live, posting, retweeting, sharing all kinds of goodies. Because Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Speaking of YouTube, subscribe to my YouTube page for all the playthroughs, past, present, future. Including all our LB Road to Shell Mode games. Including extra bonus ones where we put up. Unboxing videos, all kinds of other goodies I put up on our YouTube page. I help the cast out in some ways, and it actually helps to save you money if you're interested in any of these things. But yeah. Well, a little longer because of the issues with the cast. But hey, we're still to get through August. I mean, July, we're starting August. Next time we'll get through August. Maybe in September, we'll see. So until next time, have a good one, everyone.